All right, so you have some log footage and you're looking to get it color graded in DaVinci Resolve. Maybe you're new to DaVinci Resolve, or maybe you're an advanced user that's looking to pick up some tips and tricks. Well, in today's video, I'm gonna show you my 6-node process to color grading my videos super quick, super fast, without overcomplicating the whole dang process. Let's go ahead and jump into Resolve right now. All right, here we are, ready to color grade a project right here in DaVinci Resolve. I'm gonna assume that you know a little bit about the basics, about like what nodes are and things of that nature. If you're not sure what nodes are, basically they're layers and we're gonna build layers as we go. So this first shot I did shoot in SLOG 2. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create some additional nodes, build this thing out. I'm gonna right click, I wanna stay organized. So I'm gonna rename this node to input CST. I'm gonna also create a serial node. I can either right click and I can add a node and add a serial node. That's like adding another layer on top. So I'm gonna right click, node label this one, and I'm gonna call this one exposure. Now you can also hit Alt or Option S on your keyboard to create another node. I'm gonna go ahead and call this second node white balance. Create another node, Alt or Option S. Gonna rename this one sat/contrast. Gonna create another node here, and I'm gonna call this one output CST. If you're not sure what a CST is, I'm gonna explain that here in a second. Gonna create another node, and then I'm gonna create a layer node. And how do you do that? Once again, you can right click and you can go add node, and this time layer node, but I'm just gonna hit Alt or Option L on my keyboard, and I'm gonna call this one skin. Now there is no skin in this clip as it stands, but this is my basic node tree. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here to the input CST node. I'm gonna click on effects. I'm gonna search for color. And what I'm looking for is the color space transform. This is gonna take my log footage and convert it into whatever space I wanna put it in. So I'm gonna go ahead, drop this on here. And if we go to my project settings down here by clicking this little gear and I go to color management, you're gonna notice that I'm in DaVinci YRGB, but then I'm also in Rec 709, and I'm also in Rec 709 for output. I'm gonna convert this first node into DaVinci Wide Gamut. Why? That actually has the biggest color space possible. So I'm gonna come into my input color space and I am going to select by hitting S. I can actually hit S a couple times. I'm gonna select Sony S Gamut 3 Cine. That is how I shot this in SLOG 2. I'm gonna then pick the input gamma and I'm gonna go to SLOG 2, select that one. And already the footage is looking a lot better, but I'm gonna try and make this look even sharper, even crisper. So I'm gonna come in here to the output color space, changes to DaVinci Wide Gamut, and then I'm gonna change the output gamma to DaVinci Intermediate. So now that I have both of those selected, again, we're back to a flat image. You're thinking to yourself, what are we doing this for? Here's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to take that SLOG footage and maximize the amount of color depth that I can get out of it by expanding the color reach. Now I'm gonna come to the output CST and I'm gonna do the same thing, drop this color space transform on here, but this time your input color space is gonna be DaVinci Wide Gamut and your input gamma is gonna be DaVinci Intermediate. Now I'm gonna take that DaVinci look and I'm gonna convert it back over to Rec 709. What I am gonna do is I am going to tell DaVinci exactly the output color space and the output gamma that I want. So I'm gonna come in here to the output color space, press R and get Rec 709. And I come here to output gamma, press G, and I'm gonna get gamma 2.4. That's pretty much the standard look that you're gonna get when you're coming into like a YouTube or something of that nature. So now I can close out my effects, those are done. What I wanna do is I wanna set this same node tree up with all of my color grades. I have some SLOG 2 footage here in my first 2 nodes, and then I have SLOG 3 in these final 3 nodes. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over to this clip right here, and I am going to actually middle mouse click right here on this first clip, and that's going to apply the same exact node tree that I just set up along both of these clips. Now I'm going to come over to this third clip. This one is an SLOG 3 clip. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to middle mouse click again. Now I need to come up to this input CST. I'm going to come back into my effects, and all I'm going to do is change this to SLOG 3. And now, as you can see, the image looks properly exposed. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to select these two by holding shift. I'm going to middle mouse click on this one, and now I have my nodes all set up for my entire project. But now if we go back to this first one, I'm gonna come here to this exposure node. And what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna look at these wheels down here. So we have lift, which is gonna lift your darkest part of your image, your gamma, which is kind of those mid-tones. And then we're gonna look at gain, which is kind of like your highlights. And then your offset, that controls everything all together, your entire image. So what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna bring down the offset on this. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be darkening up the image just a little bit. And then I'm gonna come back over here to the gain and I'm gonna lift this gain gain back up. Now what that's going to do is that's going to stretch out our image a little bit, and it's going to add some contrast and saturation automatically. I'm going to hit Control D on my keyboard. That's going to deselect the node. See how it's still a little washed out without that node on there? And then I put it back on and it adds a little bit of color and contrast back to the image. So I could probably go a little bit more down on the offset and then come up a little bit more on the lip. Yeah. Yeah, that's looking nice. Look at that. Look at that door. That door is starting to pop. All right, now if I needed to adjust white balance, I can definitely do that. Now, white balance does look pretty good here. This is pretty true to life. I can come back in here to contrast and saturation. And what I can do is I can actually raise up saturation right here a little bit. Give it a little bit more of that pop. This is a little too far. And then we can kind of dial it back, maybe around like 60. There we go. Look at how much that pops. All right, maybe a little too much. Let's come back a little bit. We can also dial this down a little bit, and we can come over here to our curves, lift up our highlights a little bit, bring down our shadows. There we go. Oh, that looks good. Go ahead and print that. That thing is done. We're going to come back over here. I'm going to click on that exposure node once again. I'm going to go ahead and drop down my exposure using this offset. And if you notice how the jacket ends up darkening up a little bit, really kind of bringing that in. But if you notice, our face is a little too light. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to switch this to qualifier. You can put your qualifier over here, and you can see that it's trying to point out, there's a circle down here that will point out what you're looking at. If you're not sure how to get that circle to show up, come in here to these three dots, select display qualifier focus. So now that we have that set up, if you notice, our skin tones are kind of below that 512 line. I like to put my skin tones in between the 512 and the 640 line. So I'm going to go ahead and raise up my highlights a little bit. But I'm also going to raise up this mid-tone just enough. And now I can bring my highlights down, maybe up a little bit. There we go. And it's still looking a little washed out. Sometimes when you're shooting outside, it does get a little washed out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here to this contrast and saturation. I'm going to go ahead and once again increase my saturation to about 60. That looks pretty good. Maybe what I'm going to do is add a little bit of an S curve here. Bring this down. Oh yeah, let's look at, oh, washed out, got some pop, washed out, there's some pop. Can even get a little bit more dramatic here. Oh, now that S-Log 2 is looking pretty good. Nice. One thing that we didn't talk about yet is skin tones. Here in skin tones, we can come over to skin tones, and what we can do is we can actually qualify our skin. And what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna turn on this highlight here. Now, when we go to qualify, you can see exactly what we're qualifying. If we look at that, there's our skin tones. I'm going to come over here to vector scope. When I put my mouse over, you can see that bouncing around. But here's the deal. We want to really pinpoint that skin tone. So what we're going to do is I'm going to come over here to the mask tool. I'm going to click on this pencil. I'm going to select the skin up here on the forehead. That tends to be the one of the best places to look. And if you notice our skin tone over here in our vector scope, we need to get a little deeper. We have our 2x zoom on. That looks like it's falling right on the skin tone line. So you want to also make sure that you're showing skin tone lines here as well. Now that we have our skin tone pretty much mapped out here, deselect our mask, and we can come in here, mess with our tint sliders. If we want to make us more blue or more orange, we can mess with that. I'm going to actually leave this and just add a little bit of saturation to the face. Not too much. Want to dial that back. Maybe like a 54. Now, if you notice, the skin pops just a little bit more. All right, so we're good with this one. Great job. All right, now we're gonna move on to this one. Now, this one's backlit, so we're gonna lose a lot of contrast and saturation here because of the backlit stuff. So come back here to exposure. We're gonna switch back over to our waveform. Again, I'm gonna drop this down because we overexposed. Oh, look at that, we're saving some of the sky. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna raise up that gamma just a touch to bring back some of those skin tones. And now if we look at that, oh yeah, we added some of that contrast and saturation back. Now we're in S-Log 3 footage, and I find that S-Log 3 footage automatically adds a little bit more saturation and contrast than S-Log 2. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here. White balance looks pretty good as well. Once again, auto white balance did a great job here. Come over here to saturation and contrast. I think I might bump this up just a touch. Let's see here. Oh, just a little bit to make it pop. I can come back over here to my curves and once again, kind of raise it up, give myself a little bit of an S curve. Now we got that contrast and saturation back in there. Oh, look at that. See how like in the shirt region, it's starting to pop a little bit. Now I'm not really gonna mess around with skin tones on this. Why? Because at the end of the day, skin tones are already kind of washed out. So we're gonna kind of leave this the way it is. I'm gonna come over here to our fourth shot. And again, I'm going to look at my waveform here and I'm gonna try and get these skin tones to land between 512 and 640. If you notice, this is a very highlighted part of the image. We're probably gonna be a little bit over that 640 mark or a little bit closer to that 640 mark. So once again, I'm gonna bring down overall exposure, bring that down. Again, let's look at where our skin tones are at. If we look here, they're kind of in there, but again, I'm gonna bring up this mid-tone, this gamma, just a touch. Okay, now I think I'm actually gonna bring down the lift just a little bit and kind of finagle this and work that gamma. All right, here we are. Oh, okay, let's go. Oh, see how it gives it that extra little pop? Oh, if you like saturation and contrast, messing around with a lift gamma gain, that's gonna do it for you. I'm gonna go ahead, pump up the saturation just a little bit, maybe like 53, throw in my little S curve here. Again, we did a great job. Again, auto white balance did a great job for us. Okay, now let's say maybe I want to bring down some of the highlights on the face because maybe, you know, I'm not really liking how it's bouncing off here, but it's looking pretty good. We're gonna fine tune this. So I'm gonna go ahead. I got my highlights selected again and I'm on my skin. It looks like this is probably the best we're gonna get here. We could mess around with a couple of these sliders down here, but this is a basic tutorial. So we're just gonna kind of go with that. I do like to sometimes blur out the radius. That's gonna make the edges a little bit softer. And I also like to denoise a little bit, usually around like 10 for both. Now we gotta kind of blur it out. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take down this gain just ever so slightly. Just taking the edge off. So down to 0.94. See how it kind of just brings down the highlights a little bit and we get a little bit of that saturation and contrast back once again. So I think this one's good. We're gonna turn off everything. And then if we turn it back on, there's our final product. Here's the last one. This one is a darker image. So we're gonna come in here and we're gonna once again, lower our offset. I'd further lower that versus messing around with the lift gamma gain right off the bat. So I lowered that down. I'm gonna raise this back up in the gamma section, bring down the highlights just a little bit. Yeah, it's looking pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead and scrub through real quick, get to a spot where we can get some skin tones. Oh, look at that strike. Great job, kid. Maybe come over here. We do have some good contrast, some saturation, but I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit more into it. Come over to the curve, add a little bit of a curve here, brighten it up a little bit, and then we're gonna go ahead and back down. Oh, look at that. That's a nice moody shot. Let's go ahead, turn that off. Oh, look how you get a little extra saturation and contrast. Oh, that looks good. Can come over here to skin, and I can try and select the skin. Once again, turn on my highlight tool, and I can, there we go. Got it. Got a good little thing here. Coming to our vector scope. We're pretty much right on that line, so I'm going to leave that alone. I mean, if you wanted to, you can maybe just take down the saturation just a little bit. So subtle. That's the thing. You want to be subtle. All right. So here we go. This is our final image here. I'm really digging this. That is basically how I am going to color grade almost 99% of my footage, which is basically using 6 nodes and really trying to zip through this thing pretty quickly. If you have any questions or concerns, you want me to do additional tutorials on DaVinci color grading, please feel free to leave comments down below. I do really enjoy the color grading process. I actually think I might enjoy that more than the editing process. If you like this video, I'm sure you're going to like the video on the screen now. I appreciate you stopping by and hopefully this helps. Look forward to talking to you in the comments. Have a good day. Bye.